What's up, you guys? I'm your host, Andrew Masterson, and welcome back to the Q. Guys, this past week, we've had so many great things happen in music. We had the Billboard Music Awards, a new album from Pink came out, and Kanye West kept his mouth shut for once. It's been great. And so here to take me through the past week are some of my favorite people. Music indie pop alternative specialist, Corinna Yeager. And hip-hop specialist and good friend to the show, Jeremiah Hines. And don't forget the reason this show doesn't have therapy. Give it up for that one DJ, DJ Steven.
Woo!
All right, guys. So much, like I said, has happened this week. But three artists and three songs or three albums have really taken us by storm. And that's why they are this week's hot take. Corinna.
Yes.
Give me your hot take, baby. What do you got?
All right. It's my girl. Billie Eilish.
Oh, okay.
An icon.
All right.
Okay.
She's 17 years old. She's killing the game. Just released her first album and is top of the charts. She's the first artist born in the 2000s to hit the number one.
Look at that, Lord.
Breaking records. And she's the first female since like 2009. So my girl is representing.
She is representing. So let's do this. We actually have a clip from a music video,
yes.
Bad Guy. Let's take a look at it, then we'll talk.
Yeah, I want to see this. What's this look like? Oh, Lord. What we got going on here?
Okay. Representation.
Okay.
She's gonna go swimming.
Yeah,
and then the knees. Oh, God damn it!
Lord,
those damn knees! I can't
Bruh.
Handle the damn knees.
No, okay.
They're not that bad.
No, you can move your knees.
You're lying.
I can move my knees, but I'm not trying to point a camera at them.
Well, I guess you just have different artistic tastes.
Jeremiah, tell us what's up. What do you think?
Because I don't know. I listened to Billie Eilish's album for the first time the other day, and I was actually really surprised to find that I legitimately did enjoy it. The only thing is, I don't like that whisper thing she did.
Oh, come on. It's so fun.
Is it?
And then I don't like the
music
videos.
But they're so weird. And
they are
weird.
Can't
you appreciate, like, great art? Come on.
No, okay, here's what I will say.
They're not my cup of tea.
Here's what I will say about Billie Eilish. She is like the Edward Scissorhands of music, if that makes sense. It's a compliment.
It's a compliment, though.
It's a compliment.
Yeah,
but here's the thing. It's just like, it's not my taste.
That was
but I am proud of her, and I'm really happy of everything that she's doing. And I can't wait to see how she advances, because I want to see her advance in a different way of what she's going to do. You know what I mean?
I think that whatever path she decides to take, she's going to kill it. I think she's going to try multiple different things. And I just think she's always going to be like the one to do new. Like, she's going to be the new, the trendsetter.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
All right, Jeremiah, who do you got?
So I definitely feel like my pick is going to be the more controversial of our
Ooh.
Three.
Oh, God.
So my pick this week for our hot take is my man, Lil Nas X,
and
his song, Old Town Road.
No.
See, I don't know. You guys say no, but realistically, what do you have against it?
Everything.
Okay, what is it? Okay, first of all.
Everything.
No, no, no. First of all, I'm about to, hold up. I'm about to end y'all whole career, right?
Okay, I'm
first
ready.
Of all.
Ready
okay.
For it.
First of all, this man created a beautiful mixture between country and hip hop.
Beautiful?
Okay, you know, how about we go ahead
we
and play
We both agree. That's
no,
outrageous.
No, let's go ahead and play it. Let's
right,
take
let's,
a look here.
All right.
Yeah, take a look.
He does look like
they brought out a sleeping giant.
Okay, the fact that they had to spell his name out, like, oh, this is Billy Ray Cyrus, just so you all know, it's just like, okay, that right there.
Okay,
it looks like a joke, though.
I understand it looks weird, but at the same time, it's like, I don't know. He did that for a reason because, number one, he wasn't a really big artist before this, and this has really helped to uplift him. He didn't have the big budgets that a lot of artists have to create, like, good music, kind of like Billie Eilish. He ain't got all that. What's he got?
What?
Okay.
Billie Eilish, though, her music videos don't look like that. She's
okay.
not dancing around with the cowboy hat on.
Okay.
Trying to pretend to be she.
it's called genre.
What is
you're worked
song?
Up that I can't even speak.
It's called genre.
I can't tell.
Genre?
I can't tell.
It's
genre
two
that
damn
is.
Genres.
Yeah.
Country and rap don't go together.
Okay, well, you know what? Y'all bagging on my man. Who's your hot take? Who could you possibly put above my man Lil Nas X?
Let me breathe real quickly. Because I want you to know I do love you and I respect your opinion.
Okay.
Even though it's wrong.
Oh, shade. So much shade.
Shade, child. All right. So, my number. take a look. I'm sorry. Please cut to Jeremiah. Please. All right. Besides the point. My number one take of this past week has been somebody who's showed up time and time again and has done her business, and he's done his as well. Yes, I'm talking about the queen, Taylor Swift.
Oh, bro,
guys,
we ain't need no more of that.
Taylor Swift and Brandon Urie just released a single called Me. It's all about self-empowerment and self-love and self-confidence. The music video is beautiful. The vocals are great. Yeah. The lyrics are very simplistic, but it's all about the empowering message. I'm excited about this. Like, do you guys want to see a little bit of the music video?
Yeah,
we should probably watch it.
Oh, yeah, we definitely gonna roast it. I like the Taylor Swift. See, look at that.
I mean,
I like
your cat. I like this part.
See, this part of the video is
cool. Oh, you did get to see Brandon Urie shake. Oh, he's so cute. All right, sorry. He's a great man. He's my freebie. He's my freebie. Okay, go on.
Okay, but I don't know. I think you're not going to like me here. You're not going to like me saying this, but Taylor Swift been overrated for a decade. Brandon Urie's a pretty cool dude.
Talk to her 10 Grammys there, child. How many does Lil Nas have?
You got me there.
I'm not even going to lie. You got me there. But still, I really like Me as a music video. I just don't think the song is very quality.
I think it relies on its music video, if we're being honest. And, like, them, they're great. Separate, together, I don't know. It's just, like, I think that's why it sold is because they're such big names.
Yeah.
See, that's – okay, I do agree that it doesn't hurt them that it's Brandon Urie and Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
I don't
– But you're going to listen.
I don't hate on that, but what I do think is that you never knew that their voices blended so well together. And honestly, I think that their voice, I'm like, okay, like, this is good. And I don't know, I just think, especially with all the bullshit that's going on, all the bullshit that's going on in the world, we need some uplifting songs.
But you don't think it's like a little bit too cheesy? You're not just like a little bit.
That's the best part of it. It's a little cheesy.
I guess that's where like our tastes differ.
I like a little cheese in my cheesecake, okay? Like,
that's too much cheese.
It's not a cheesecake without the cheese. It's just a damn cake.
Music videos are like a sandwich. You can't have too much cheese.
Lactose intolerant.
What the hell's going on here? All right. So here's what we're going to do. We're now going to send it to you guys. Who do you guys think is the hot take of the week? Is it going to be Billie Eilish? Is it going to be Lil Nas X? Or is it going to be Taylor Swift? Support by going to our website and clicking on the artist. And then you get to choose who's the hot take of the week. Yes, you at home eating the popcorn with your glass of wine. I respect you.
That sounds like a good night.
That's a great night.
Why am I not doing that?
And while you're doing that, just freaking get on your phone. Click on an artist, and woohoo, we're all winners here. But guys, other than that, we have a great show. Once we come back from break, that one DJ is going to show me a little trick.
I'm
super excited. This is a long time coming. We're going to play one of my favorite games. This show is just so good, y'all.
I'm excited.
So good. We're going to play a game. Somebody's going to go home with something. It might be fantastic. And then we'll figure out by the end of the show who's the hot take of the week, and I might sing a little. I don't know. So here's what we're going to do. Corinna, is there any last words for Billie Eilish before we go? One word.
I mean, she speaks for herself, so.
Jeremiah?
I love my man.
All right. Stick with us. We'll come right back, and this is the cue. Stick with us.
Attention. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Mesothelioma is a rare cancer linked to asbestos exposure. Exposure to asbestos in the mills, the shipyards, construction, or the Navy construction may put you at risk. Please don't hesitate to call. Call 1-800-88-LAW-USA to get your free legal consultation. Please don't wait. Call us now. 1-800-88-LAW.
Let's send me in by myself. I'm doing Jesus Christ, okay? Can't jump on me, boy. That was smooth. Here we go. We're gonna let it roll. Good shot. This is everything that gave me anxiety as a child. God damn! To get in the room with me. Hey everybody, Exempt here. Come join my Twitch community at the link shown here. I'm always trying to provide new quality content from classic games to new releases, competitive games, and story-driven playthroughs. So come hang out and join the chat. Suggest what music you want to hear or what games you want to see. Be sure to follow and share to help the channel's growth. Remember, the more the channel grows, the better the content I can provide for you. Thanks for watching and welcome, newcomers. See you soon.
And welcome back to the Cube, my lovely human beings that I call friends. Have you ever thought, while you're drinking your wine on the couch, have you ever thought, tonight, I'm going to be a DJ? Well, tonight's your lucky night because our DJ that we love so much is going to show us a few tricks. But before we do that, let's just show you guys, what does he do when he's not in the studio? Check it out. And that's that. Dude, I'm so excited that we're doing this.
Definitely.
Huh. Oh my gosh. Okay, so first step, what do we do?
So first things first is we got to pick some songs.
Okay, wait, do I choose the songs?
Yeah.
Well, I'll be dang. Okay. Here's what we'll do. I'm looking at your list. Good songs, by the way.
Thanks, man.
Here's what we'll do. Because DJ's very like up vibe, like feel good song, let's start with Uptown Funk.
All right.
Okay. And then after Uptown Funk, can we do Daft Punk Get Lucky?
For sure. Yeah. Let me get these pulled up real quick.
All right.
And then so basically from here, we'll get these tracks loaded in. Okay. We'll start with, let's say, start with Uptown Funk, right?
Okay.
So once those are loaded in, we're going to get the first track going.
This song never gets old.
No, not at all. So then step two, you know, we're going to want to blend the next track into this, yeah, right? So we have the next song loaded up, and then we're just going to basically do what's called beat matching. You pull that up in the headphones.
This is so amusing to watch on the like computer. Just
all the pretty colors.
Just the pretty colors.
Yeah.
It's so, I love it. Uh-huh.
So we get the other one lined up. It's ready to go in. And then we bring it in generally at the breakdown. That's not necessarily what you always have to do. It's a case-by-case basis. But in this instance, that's what we're going to do.
Oh, okay. Okay. That was smooth.
And then you let out the new track and let it come in. And then we'll blend the old one out.
Dude, that's beautiful. Okay, so for everyone at home who doesn't know, like, what got you into DJing? Because I never get to talk about it on the show.
Well, honestly, what got me into it is... I've always loved music and sound design and things like that. And so I went to a big name electronic artist's show, and he looked super happy and like just was loving life. And I was like, you know what? I want to do that.
Yeah.
And so I bought a small cheap controller, taught myself how to do it in about 6 months, and then got my first club gig. And then here we are 10 years later.
10 years, people. This is where it's at. Okay, so how do we now transfer it back to Uptown Funk?
All right, so we're going to go back to it. We're going to do the exact same steps, basically.
Okay.
So we'll get the old track queued up. We'll bring that into the headphones, and we'll beat match that.
Okay.
With what's playing right now.
Gosh. I forgot how good these songs are.
They are. I mean, they're a little old now, but
well,
they're still...
They're going to be classics.
They really are.
I mean, you can be 80 years old and be like, that was a damn bop.
You can still play them all the time.
Exactly.
In the club.
Nobody
people
will
still
get tired
love
of
it.
Them.
No, you really... no one gets tired of them, man.
All right, so after we get back to Uptown Funk, can you show me, like, these glowing buttons that I get to touch?
Definitely,
really
definitely,
to
definitely. I'll demonstrate something on it real quick.
Okay,
when
awesome.
We bring in the new track.
Okay, they mix so well together. Like these songs, I. Wow!
So basically, what happened here is I've got a series of effects tied to one button.
Okay.
And what those do is when I want to mix something out real fast, you know, you're in a pinch and you got to get out of something real fast.
Yeah.
I got one button that does an echo fade, which is what you just heard. And so it sounds really cool.
Okay.
And so we'll bring that out, and now it's in the active deck. And if you want to play around with it, man, these are all just effects that control the music, and it sounds crazy.
Let's go! All right. it. Let's start with this one.
Yeah, man. Ooh. Oh. There you go. Oh, you're having way too much fun, man.
I'm doing it!
Yeah, you are. That's awesome. And that's not far off of what you need, just timing. It's all about timing.
Let me just say this. I don't think people really understand how complex being a DJ is. Like, they just think that you add a song on the queue at Spotify, and then it's all good. But, like, really looking at this, like, there's so many elements that you get to play with, and it just makes it more fun and energetic. So I really like that about this.
Oh, for sure, man. Like, there's an awful lot to it.
And my earpiece is coming out.
And, you know, for the biggest thing is for anybody new coming into this that is interested in it, definitely don't feel like you have to go out and buy all this.
Oh, yeah, this year. Is probably a lot of money.
It's a lot of money, A, and then B, it's too overwhelming. Otherwise, you're going to get too, like, you're going to look at all this and there's going to be all these knobs and buttons and you're not going to know what the hell to do.
Yeah.
And it's just not a good idea. So start with something small. And then work your way up to something like this. And then when you have this much stuff, you can, like, your imagination's, the sky's the limit.
Yeah, and that's the thing, is that I think DJs, like, get to, like, play with a bunch of things, and that's what makes them kind of like artists in themselves, because it's like you get to be creative and just, like, have a time of your life, but also just, like, choose these songs that everybody loves. It's like, let me show you what I can do.
Definitely.
So, dude, I'm so excited that we actually got to do this. This has literally been a long time coming, and it's happened.
Yeah,
we are doing it. And so here's what we're going to do. We're going to come back after commercial, and then we're gonna play a game. And when we have to play the game, we're gonna learn our must takes of the week. All right, we're gonna take a quick commercial break. This is the cue.
Hey, right over here, bruv. So you got some trapped lips right there. But boy, do I got something for you. It's $1 pop, or I can give you four for $5.
I ain't got any money on me, man.
I'm feeling generous, though, so, you know, free trial, knock yourself out.
Thanks, man.
Hey, no problem, bruv. Hey, don't use it all at once, though. You'll get a tummy ache.
Do not use if you are pregnant or plan to become pregnant. Prices may vary upon location, time of the year. This is a CDU product.
And welcome back to the queue, ladies and gentlemen. So, everybody knows the importance to a song is partially the hook, because the hook is what brings you into the action. But today, the hook is going to yank two of our contestants out of their noggins because they just don't have any common sense. It is time for one of my favorite games here on the show. This is The Hook. The hook brings you back. All right, and now let's meet our contestants. Hi, guys. I'm so excited. Okay, so you are Autumn, correct?
Yes.
Hi, Autumn. Welcome. Devin.
That's right.
I love that jacket,
Thank
Devin.
Thank you so much.
And you are Bailey, correct?
Yes, I am.
Hi, Bailey. That bow tie is polka dotty, and I like it.
Thank you.
All right, guys, let me explain to you guys the rules to this game. I'm going to have, right in front of me, I have a list of songs. I'm going to tell you to give me a song that has one word in it.
Okay.
Do it in 5 seconds and don't repeat, and you stay in the game. If you break one of those rules, you'll lose a life, 2 lives lost, and you'll get hooked by something aggressive and could possibly kill you.
Uh-oh.
Okay? So, well, yeah, Autumn, you're fine. Bailey, exciting. You're fine. Sorry, Bailey. Autumn. Bailey.
Am I fine?
all you're fine. All right, so we're going to start with you, Autumn, okay?
Okay.
Easy. Song that has the word love in it. Go.
Okay. Love.
Oh,
love.
Okay, yeah,
I got mine.
We're good.
Love.
3 seconds.
Really?
This life is highway. This is going to be an easy one.
Yeah,
this is
going to
be an easy
one. Autumn. Literally, Love is a Highway. It's not even that good of a song. I Will Always Love You by Whitney Houston.
Classic.
You Give Love a Bad Name. Love Song. Bleeding Love. Love Story. Like, and you said Love is a Highway. Yeah.
That's bad. That's really bad.
That's really bad.
It's okay. I'll try to forgive you. But here's what we'll do. You just lose a life, although I want to make you lose both already. But we won't. We won't.
The shade.
We should.
Just get your crap together.
Shouldn't be here.
All right. Devin, it's time with you, bub, okay?
Okay.
All
right,
give me a song that has the word baby in it. Song that has the word baby.
Baby.
Go.
Baby by Justin Bieber. That's
right.
It's an easy one. It's a classic, right?
Baby, one more time.
Britney Spears, I love it.
Yeah.
All right, Autumn.
Baby Shark.
I'll take Baby Shark. Okay. Devin.
You guys stole all my answers, so let me just think.
Well, you have 3 seconds.
Game, come on.
Yeah, I got one.
You sure?
I don't have one.
Not okay.
Devin.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Devin. I mean, even the classic holiday song, Baby, It's Cold Outside.
Oh, Christmas song. Oh, yes. Christmas songs.
Yeah.
Okay.
A lot of Christmas songs have the word baby in it. All I want for Christmas is you, baby.
That's good.
All right. Here we go. So, 2 of you have lost a life. Bailey, you're doing good.
Yeah, I am.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here we go.
We got this.
Coming to you, Bailey. Song that has the word heart in it. Heart.
That's easy.
Heart?
That's really easy.
Like this thing?
No, I'm saying fart this thing. Yes, heart that thing. Go.
Heart? Okay.
Seriously?
I'm only going to give you about 3 more seconds.
Seriously? I should know this because I got heart surgery just later today.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I am struggling right now.
Clearly,
there's a freaking Titanic song, My Heart Will Go On, and you couldn't even say that?
What? Titanic?
When you were not having
Classic.
Heart surgery,
yeah,
did Celine Dion not like sing to you?
I'm pretty sure they're playing in the background.
It's fine.
It was my request.
Everybody, hey, it's all good. Everybody's lost at least one life, but that means somebody's about to get hooked. I'm super excited.
Okay. Please don't come from the ceiling.
All right. Okay, so Autumn, we're going to start with you.
Okay,
give me a song that has the word dance in it. Go.
Just Dance.
Okay.
We'll take it. All right.
Shut Up and Dance. Walk the Moon.
We'll take it.
It works.
Whoa, okay, you Bailey? Say the person. Okay, dance. I can't dance right now because my
3 seconds.
You know?
It's not a song.
Like,
it's not a song.
Let's go. Let's dance.
Oh, Bailey.
No.
I Hope You Dance by Leanne Womack.
Oh, my heart.
I like that one.
But I'm actually getting told. Hold up. Okay, sounds good. So we're actually getting sued for the hook because it was too aggressive and somebody almost died. So you actually just get to walk off.
Oh, seriously?
Yeah, so bye. Okay. Bye, Bailey.
Oh, my heart.
All right, guys. All right. Down to you two. One of you guys is going to go home with a grand prize that is unlike anything else, okay?
That's going to be me.
Here we go.
No.
We're going to start with Devin.
Okay.
Devin.
All right.
A song that has the word girl in it. Song that has the word girl. Go.
Uptown Girl.
We'll take it.
Okay. All right, it works.
Autumn.
My Girl.
Temptations.
Yeah.
Classic. Love it. Devin.
What else? There can't be any other girl songs, right?
There is.
Barbie Girl. That's.
Oh.
Yeah.
Barbie Girl.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll take.
I mean, technically.
All American Girl by Carrie Underwood.
I love Carrie Underwood. Yes.
That's not good.
All right.
Kevin. My girl. You didn't. You said that.
That was my first song.
She said that the first round.
Really?
Yeah.
Man.
Oh, Devin.
Am I
you were so close. You were doing really good. I'm proud of you.
I lost both lives?
You lost both lives.
Oh, man.
But at least you don't get that aggressive hook I was talking about. You can just walk off. Do you
want
to wave to the camera?
Bye.
Bye, Devin, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Autumn, that means you're the winner. I am so excited to give you this. Okay. Here's the thing, all right?
Okay.
We were going to bring Beyonce into the studio.
Beyonce's here?
Beyonce is not here. She is being a mother to Blue. And sir,
we love a strong woman. It's
yes.
okay.
Yes.
It's
okay. Okay. But here's what we got instead. Are you ready?
Yeah.
We got you a cardboard cutout of Beyonce. Hey, look at her. You can hold her. You can shower. Well, actually, don't shower with her because it's cardboard. But you can have breakfast with her. Look at her. She's so pretty. Autumn, take care of her, okay? Congratulations.
With my life.
And we'll also, on the side, we'll give you a $500 gift card to Best Buy. How about that? There we go. All right, guys, it's it. We are getting ready to take a break. When we come back, we are going to say the hot take of the week. All right? We'll be right back. I might sing with you, but I love you. This is the cue. We'll be right back, guys.
Wow, conveniently placed crackers in a place like this? Dinograms. I couldn't tell you how many times these crackers saved my life. They have 0 grams of trans fat and cholesterol. They also have 2 grams of protein. And they're absolutely delicious. Mmm. So good. Even a dinosaur would eat them.
Dinograms. So delicious, a dinosaur would eat them.
There's a simple beauty to a good shave and a clean haircut. But hidden behind that simplicity is a complex relationship between a man and his barber. A relationship that spans generations of history going all the way back to the era of the gentleman. A time where men were clothed in their finest, drank gin and tonic over cards, and treated each other with the respect that the classic golden rule demands. In those days, barbers were considered artists, craftsmen dedicated to elevating their clients' lives with healthy conversation, a good clean cut, and an atmosphere that could relax even the burliest of men. It is this history, this legacy, that Dapper aspires to. We believe that there's a gentleman in all of us, and our passion is to help every person who walks through that door find their true self. In the meantime, we want you to enjoy yourself. Our curated packages allow for your stay here to be one of entertainment and rejuvenation. Have a drink on us and enjoy the back and forth banter. Cold cucumber eye peels are applied after one of our signature haircuts while you enjoy a brisk shampoo. Steam towels are infused with essential oils to make your face glow as it should, followed by a cold pack towel to seal in all the nutrients. Some call it luxury, but we call it the Dapper experience. A time to sit back and appreciate the finer things. Good people, good beer. And a good time.
We're back, guys. It's time. Before we go, let's take some time to announce the nominees for today's hot take. So if you just came into the show, I got you. Don't worry. We had Corinna choosing Billie Eilish's new song, When We All Fall Asleep. My choice of the week was Taylor Swift and Brendon Urie's new single, Me. And then we had Jeremiah bring us a Lil Nas X featuring Billy Ray, Old Town Road. We tallied up all your guys' votes from home. Thank you so much for voting. We crashed our internet system here, so thank you so much. But there can only be one winner. And the our hot take of the week goes to my personal favorite, Taylor Swift and Brendon Urie's Me. Hey! Guys, it's such a beautiful song. It's all about self-empowering and just loving yourself. But also, when you're listening to this song, if you've not yet, or watching the video, go ahead and check Billie Eilish out. Go ahead and check out Old Time Road. I might be wrong on some takes, and that's okay. We're all human. We all make mistakes. But that's what makes us beautiful, guys. And so I just want to thank Corinna, my good friend Corinna, and Jeremiah for sharing their hot takes with us today. This show wouldn't have been anything without them. Also want to thank our DJ, that one DJ, DJ Steven. Guys, I had so much fun, and I hope you had as much fun watching it as I did.
And also just congrats to our winner of our game. I love the hook. So congratulations to Miss Autumn. Take care of Beyonce for us. I mean, she is our queen, the one queen. And to our other contestants, just better luck next time. Now, before we say go, I want to sing a classic song that has the word bye in it. I know that I can't take no more. It ain't no lie. I wanna see you out that door, baby. Bye, 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 bye. Bye, guys. I love you all. We'll see you next time. This is The Cue.